You're watching today. Jerry Springer, the longtime host, best known for his raucous show, has died age 79. US correspondent Lauren Tomasi has more. Lauren, he was the king of confrontational daytime TV.
And his show was absolute TV royalty, Carl. Jerry Springer, such an icon of talk television, not just here in America, but he was loved globally for those really confrontational, his raucous shows on the Jerry Springer Show. There were arguments, chair throwing, physical confrontations. Look, nothing was off limits, and certainly there were many profanity-prone guests who often had to be restrained by security on set. The show ran from 1991 for 27 years, almost 5,000 episodes. And in every single one of them, fans were chanting for Jerry.
Thanks for the 25 years. We've signed on to do a whole bunch more. And as long as I stay healthy, we will. And on that note, take care of yourself and each other.
Before he was a TV host, Jerry Springer actually dabbled in politics. He was the one-time mayor of Cincinnati and actually ran for Congress before taking on his own TV show. A family spokesperson has issued a statement this morning. He says Jerry's ability to connect with people was at the heart of his success in everything he tried, whether that was politics, broadcasting, or just joking with people on the street who wanted a photo or a word. Carl, Jerry Springer died at his home in Chicago after a brief illness. He had pancreatic cancer. Jerry Springer was 79.
Got me through uni, Springer did. Good on you, Lauren. Thank you, Sarah.
The king of daytime TV, Jerry Springer, has died aged 79. For almost 30 years, he brought us some of TV's most explosive moments.
This comment is for the tranny that's in the pool.
Yes, honey.
I think your body on backwards.
For Mr. Brokeback Mountain himself, I think you belong in the pool because apparently you like the sausage party. No way you didn't know that was a man.
Hey, I can't help it. Come on with it.
Toy Story is glad to meet you. And how was it meeting Buzz Lightyear today?
I think you should see if you are entitled to any educational benefits, because if your career goal is being a rapper, you're going to spend a lot of time in the unemployment line.
Besides you, baby.
My recommendation is to get rid of the mirror, because it doesn't matter what time you look, you're still going to be ugly.
Ooh, I'm not sure anyone would get away with any of that stuff these days. Ooh, the times have changed. Today, entertainment reporter Sam Rubin joins us live now in LA. Whew, that was a bit of a flashback, wasn't it?
You know, Sarah, it's the most remarkable thing. He was the ringmaster over an appalling circus, but there was this Teflon-like quality to Jerry Springer. It never stuck to him. So even though the show was absolutely awful, it was phenomenally successful for decades. And Springer himself, this grateful, humble man, always in good humor, he was on our morning program in Los Angeles several times over the years. Here's one exchange.
Do you ever roll your eyes?
Do you ever watch the news?
Right.
What on my show have you not seen on the news or in the White House? On a serious answer,
yes.
That's not permissible.
Okay.
No, because the contract we have is that our show has to be about outrageous people and outrageous behavior. If I went in tomorrow and said I'd like to do a show on the impact of inflation on the world bond market, they'd say, get another show. Well, I certainly enjoy this opportunity to anchor the morning show here. And, you know, we're here every Monday through Friday, so be sure to catch us. And, this is fantastic. I tell you what, let's bring them on out. This is unbelievable.
Here, Jerry, come here.
Desk. He was a television anchorman for 10 years, the mayor of Cincinnati, Ohio. He considered running to be the governor of Ohio. So even though, again, it was this clown car of a television show, he was sort of an intelligent and serious man. And for better, good or for ill, has he changed culture forever? Some analysts here in the States, Sarah, are saying there would be no Kardashians. There would be no reality TV if not for Jerry Springer, who, again, put people on television who had never been seen on television before.
Well, that's exactly right. I mean, the closest we come to Jerry Springer these days is reality television, that's for sure. I mean, you've touched on him being so loyal and caring. How do you think he will be remembered as we see his family release a statement?
Well, I tell you what, I think there are two Jerry Springers. There is the personal Jerry Springer, described as a real mensch, a very, very nice guy, always time for a fan, always time for a family member. And then the professional legacy. Here's what his family said. Jerry's ability to connect with people was at the heart of his success in everything he tried, whether that was politics, broadcasting, or just joking with people on the street who wanted a photo or a word. His family went on to say how very much people felt like he was everybody's math teacher. You know, it was somebody that you knew from school.
Yeah.
An extraordinary career. He was on television here close to 30 years. That show had 12 million viewers a day.
Wow.
More than Oprah Winfrey, more than several other talk show hosts.
Imagine those numbers. Incredible legacy. Thanks so much for your time, Sam. Appreciate it.
Sam Rubin on fire this morning. Terrific, mate. Thank you. Just